Present company is gathered to reiterate the Cienjo Lawfu's esteemed gratitude for the magnanimous actions of the Nameless. I am sure Lady Fu has given voice to this already, but the Lawfu is greatly indebted to you. Therefore, on behalf of the Lawfu Cloud Knights, I hereby present you with a jade abacus, a symbol of our allied friendship. Back when the Alliance was first established, all those thousands of years ago, the Cienjo ships swore an oath, etching the record into a jade abacus. The world may crumble, and the heavens may fall, but this oath shall never be broken. The same is true of this jade abacus. It is a record of the Lawfu Cloud Knight's promise to the crew of the Astral Express. It is also a beacon. Grip it tightly, and it will send a message to the jade abacus here in my hand. No matter how astronomically distant you are, the Lawfu Cloud Knights will always come to the aid of the crew, whatever your need may be.
Wow, now that's what I call a payoff.
Of course, I trust that such an important article will not be used for trivial or inappropriate circumstances. I hope you can understand.
Yep, got it. Say no more, sure thing.
Thank you for your generosity, General.
Don Hung.
General.
In accordance with the edict of the Ten Lords Commission, I am hereby authorized to relieve your banishment decree. From this day henceforth, you may come and go freely on the Lawfu.
Nice!
But I must remind you that the crimes of Don Fung have had far-reaching implications. And some people, such as those in Scale Gorge Waterscape, will not be much moved by the issuance of a paper edict. While I can guarantee your freedom to come and go as you please, I cannot guarantee your safety. Again, I hope you can understand.
I understand.
This issuing of gifts brings with it a sense of relief. Even my wound is feeling much improved. The occasion calls for a line or two of poetry. Though I feel my efforts would be overshadowed by the erudition of Lady Fu. Another time, perhaps. The Express and its passengers have a long voyage ahead of them. May that voyage be smooth and untrammeled. I bid you farewell.
Himiko messaged me. The Express detected the Jade Gates reopening. She asked whether we'd be heading back anytime soon. She was also asking after you, Don Hung. I think it'd be best if you update her in person, don't you think?
She must have been worried. I'll return to the train and put her mind at rest.
Himiko must be eager to hear about what we've been up to on this mission too, right? Hang on. Oh, how could I forget? We should bring something back for the conductor. Have you got any unfinished business on the Cienjo? Oh yeah, there are some people we haven't said goodbye to yet.
Fine, fine. Don Hung and I will go back to the Express. The two of you come back soon, okay?
Don't worry, Mr. Yang.
There's a dreamlike quality to watching these star skiffs depart through the Jade Gate. How long will these ships sail? And which stars are they traveling to?
From a universal perspective, there is little difference between the lives of long and short life species. The transcendence that the Xianzhou pursues is nothing compared to the enduring majesty of the stars. And the grief felt here is no different from our own. Yeah, you're back. Himeko and I were just discussing our journey. This little excursion has reached its conclusion. All things must come to an end. Still, some endings spark a new beginning.
Next time, I think I should be the one trailblazing with you guys. Welk can stay on the Express.
Since when did the work roster just change like that?
Penacony, do you remember? Before Kafka's proposal, that was our original destination. The Express's records show that Penacony was a prison planet used by the IPC to exile criminals. At least, it was at the time of recording. However, following a Stellaron burst, the planet fell into the arms of Shipe. They say it's been transformed into a prosperous and ethereal realm. The family is throwing a banquet there, and they sent invitations out to the Express. I was curious about the state of the planet, so I accepted. When the conductor is ready, we can set off for the next stop.
All who enter here are either jailers or prisoners. Which are you?
Neither. I'm merely a lost traveler.
What a spectacle. The Stellaron, the Ambrosial Arbor, the Disciples of Sanctus Medicus, the Lord Ravager. A series of threats that almost succeeded in diverting attention away from the crucial question. They who brought the Stellaron onto the Xianzhou, what was their motive? Will you surrender, or do you require encouragement? Abomination of Yaoshi.
General, my power does indeed stem from the Abundance. But I'm the same as you. We are both enemies of Yaoshi.
That's right, Jingyuan. Stay out of our way. The revival of the Arbor is an omen. It's time for the Xianzhou to choose its next path. The Rainbow Arbiter, the Plague's Author, the Ruin Author. This is a chess game between eons. If you don't stand with the winners, you stand to lose. And this time, we will put the Abundance in their grave.